Bonjour tout le monde, hello everyone, hope you're all doing well. In this video I'm going to be discussing a few things that were changed in the latest update of the BEBOP 2 firmware version 4.4 and the Sky Controller version 1.0.7. In the new update there were two improvements and two fixes. The first improvement is the critical battery warning and emergency landing. Your critical battery warning will come in at 10% and your drone will automatically land at 2%. The second improvement is the decrease in horizontal speed during the reveal function. Now, reveal is a function in the Droney's features. When you open Droney's features, you have a reveal function there. What this does is fly the drone forwards, starting off with the camera facing down and then tilting the camera upwards to have that reveal effect. Previously, a lot of people were having accidents with this because they didn't estimate the distance well and the drone just slammed into something. Now with this reduced speed, people can estimate a lot better where it's going to be going, how fast it's going to get there, and also your video is going to be really, really smooth. In addition to this, return to home is now possible during these features and landing. The next bug fix is related to the maximum altitude during the tap to go. Now, I'm not too sure what this does, but if someone has any information about this, please feel free to write them down in the comments. Now to my personal review after the update. I've noticed that my battery flight time has now increased to 22 minutes and 13 seconds when I was previously doing 21 minutes and 45 seconds. Critical battery warning comes in at 10% as stated in the update, and this is good. It glows red on your screen saying critical, 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 and lands your drone at 2%. This is good for people like me who tend to forget to land their drone or just wait for it to fall out of the sky with a dead battery. I've also noticed that there's a lot more responsiveness in the controls when flying it manually with the Sky Controller 2. Whether this was reflected in the update or not, I've noticed that it's a lot more responsive after the update. There's also some noticeable improvements with the live video feed from the drone on my little Android phone. Previously it used to lag a bit, but now I'm getting crisp, clear, and responsive images. There's also no change to the follow me mode, as that was all corrected in the previous update and it still works perfectly fine. There have been no improvements to the flight plan, as flight plan was corrected in the previous update also, and everything works flawlessly. Thank you all so much for watching this video. It was a pleasure discussing the new update with you. If you have any questions, please write them in the comments. If I've made a mistake, please write them in the comments. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you don't like this video, give me a thumbs down. And please tell me why you gave me a thumbs down. Until next time, safe flying and God bless.